smell on that car?
Let's definitely check your mirror. Signal. Now pull into traffic. Try and ease off on the brake. Give it a little gas.
I know a shortcut. Turn left here. There he is.
Easy.
Turn right. Follow him to the right.
It's okay. Now, normally, you would not be going 65 down the wrong way of a one-way street. Apply the brakes. Now put it in reverse. Stephanie, gently extend your arm. Extend your middle finger. Very good. Well done.
Communion After Dark.
Giants, where are you from? Counting the joy. had something inside my head. No sympathy, no sympathy. My medication made me feel undead. No sympathy, no sympathy. And when I couldn't relax on account of my panic attacks, you told me you had enough, just take some Atarax. And when I went to my scans, as I was dreading my death, you had more pressing concerns. I got your message. You keep on digging at the crossroads.
Keep on digging at the crossroads. No sympathy. No. your call. Death to the future, a world so sad and gray. Death to the future, waste not the end in just a grave. Death to the future, I know you feel the same. Death to the future, waste not the end in just a grave. How many checks sit on a throne? Or die fiasco. Well, everybody dies to real. Follow is a sham and privacy. We want it all, we overpay. We get it all,
I'll make your call.
Death to the future, a world so sad and gray. Death to the future, but it's not the end, it's just a grave. Death to the future, pretend everything's okay. We dress up and smile. We say we are fine. Everything's gonna fall in place. Everyone's gonna dance in chains. Too little, too late. No one is safe. We'll be right back.
to enter me. I want to feel you next to me. I want to hold your hand so tight, but you're so far away from me. In the day, so many faces pass me by. In the day, I keep on searching for you. In the night, I toss and turn as I'm whispering your name, but you're not there. You're so far away from me.
Community After Dark, we are back. It is the week of September 28th, and we are joined today by a very special guest, Tom Scheer from Assemblage 23. Yeah, very excited to have him on the show.
Welcome.
Yes.
Thank you very much. I'm excited to be here.
Yes, we're very happy to have you on. And he will be coming up with a guest DJ set. We'll also talk to him as well about his new album and probably ask him some additional questions of, you know, whatever comes to mind. But you just heard my set. I started off the show. Last time you heard my set was by a band called Technomancer. And the track you heard was I Want You. That was the Echo Image remix, which I haven't heard much from Echo Image in quite a while. So it's pretty cool that they actually remixed the track.
Yeah,
and that was off the...
still active.
Yeah, no, me either. I was like, wow. And then I was like, I had to listen to it because I really enjoyed the album that came out in whatever year it was, now on different drum, back in like the early 2000s.
Yep.
That was off the I Want You single, which you can pick up on Bandcamp currently. The sixth song in my set was by a band called Hell Boulevard. That was the track Death to the Future, featuring Faderhead. on that track. And that is on their brand new album called Not Sorry on No Cut Entertainment. That is Mono Inc's label and a handful of other bands, but Mono Inc, I believe, is the one who actually started that label. Good goth rock album if you're into that style. Something to check out. The fifth song I said was by Suicide Commando. He is back with he actually redid Mindstrip. So the new album is called Mindstrip Redux. The song I played was Jesus Wept, and that was the Resurrect version 2020. So brand new version he put out there for the Redux album, and that's on Out of Line Records. He redid most of the tracks on there, and then the second disc you can get the originals, from the album.
All right, the fourth song in Paradise's set was brand new Ashbury Heights. They're back, and not just that, it's with Yaz, who is the original singer on the first album that they put out. So she's featured on this track. This was the song called Spectres from the Black Moss single. And you can get it on Bandcamp right now.
Yeah, pretty cool. I was not expecting something new from them.
I haven't heard anything
about that. That just popped up. What'd you say?
I'm a Black Moss.
What? Oh my, all right.
It's not a good joke, sorry.
All right, prior to that, we heard brand new X Marks the Pedwalk with a song called Sunrise from their latest release called Transformation out on Meshwork Music. Great album.
Amazing.
Very good album.
I'm a big fan.
We're lucky to see him 1 year at WGT, and that was great.
I've never had the pleasure, but I think their albums are just amazingly produced. They just sound incredible, and the new one in particular, I think, is probably my favorite of the ones that they've released since they kind of made their quote unquote comeback.
Yeah. Right. No, he's always been. I mean, his production has always been amazing.
Yeah.
Even with the older stuff they had done prior to the hiatus, I always thought he was, like some of those side projects he had done, like PAX and some of those other ones, pretty amazing.
Yeah. Every side project he does is good.
The second track in my set was by a band called Cat Tack. I guess that's how you would say it, Cat Tack. That is a new single that was just released. The song is called The Sorrow in Me, and that is off their upcoming album, Filthy Tendrils, which you can get through Darktoons Music Group. That is up for pre-order right now on the Darktoons Bandcamp. And thank you to Raphael for sending over the track for us to play on the show. Oh, I'm sorry. I started my set off with our guest, Assemblage 23, with the song Welcome Apocalypse. That is off his brand new album, Mourn, which you can buy on Metropolis Records. And we have played, I believe, the remix from that previously. Tom had played that, Mr. Gold, I'm sorry, had played that. And that was, I believe, the Alpha Quadrant remix you played prior.
Uh-huh.
A number of shows back.
Another Florida native.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Well, not native, but they're based in Florida, yeah.
Yeah.
What's the idea behind that song specifically?
So Welcome Apocalypse is probably the newest song on the album. And I wrote that probably around early April. It was around the time that we started seeing the first face mask protests.
Okay.
Where people didn't want to wear masks.
Mm-hmm.
And I was watching this on the news and I thought, God, the end of the world is so much stupider than I thought. You know?
Yeah.
It was kind of jaw dropping. So, the song is kind of tongue in cheek, saying that maybe as a species we're too stupid and too selfish to really deserve our continued existence. I don't really want the apocalypse to come. Life is pretty good,
right?
But
yes.
So it was kind of born out of the frustration of a situation that could relatively easily be handled and controlled, but people being ignorant enough to not want to
exactly
cooperate.
Great. Well, I love that track. Really, really good track. And
thank you.
Your lyrics, as always, stand out, which I love about your music. I'm very big into lyrics, and I love your lyrics.
Well, thank you very much.
So let's go ahead, and I know Mr. Shure is going to cheer us on. We're going to do our shot of the week for our show here. So cheers.
Wait.
You guys have yours? Oh, no. Okay.
Got it.
That's a big shot, Tom.
Cheers. Oh, yeah.
Oh, look, mine's gross.
That is a big boy shot.
Yeah.
All right. That's for cheers. Sure.
Drink your drink.
No.
Mouse. Did not like
I'm
it,
good
almost.
At making drink.
No. Okay. What was in that you just drank?
I had pink lemonade vodka and guava nectar.
What?
That sounds like a
it's something I got in a
glass.
Can.
Yeah, for sure.
Guava nectar. I figured you know
fairly,
that.
Yeah, no, that was fairly strong, the one I had. It was 99 pineapple mixed with peach schnapps. That was good. It was tasty. It went down smooth. It wasn't too... I don't know why I had a peach schnapps. That was just something that was in my cabinet. I was like,
yeah, 99 peaches over here.
And Gold, what was your big drink there that you had?
It was chilled Gold Patron.
Well, there's our shot of the week. And I hope you chime along with us at home. We've had now, I think we got 5 or 6 videos now of people doing shots of the week with us. So we need some more. We can we're getting close to where we can start putting them together, maybe make a little reel, highlight reel of them.
Yeah.
I got my flu shot this week, if that counts.
That's good. Yeah, that's a good
now
one.
Now drink your drink. Yeah. Getting a shot for the fly.
Take your medicine.
So, yeah, that's important. Go get your flu shot. I know I got mine this week, too. All right, so we're going to speak with Mr. Shure here in a little bit about the album. We have some more questions to ask him. Before we go to who's next, Gold's going to be next on the show.
Am I next?
So, okay. Yeah, I wanted to just announce that we do have a bonus show up real quick that we put up. If you would like to check that out, it's on YouTube and Mixcloud. That was Side Projects, which actually we did play one of Mr. Shear's side projects as well on that bonus show. It's just a straight mix. Our bonus shows, as we've announced before, and you can download it directly from our website as well. But Mouse, did you want to ask about what was the side project you played? Because I know it was in your set, right?
No,
it was in Gold's. Oh,
Gold,
it was in Gold's set.
Surveillance.
Surveillance.
Yeah,
that's
yeah,
right.
Yeah, Surveillance. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I was going to ask. I was going to ask if Tom, if you had plans on doing any more work with some of your side projects like Surveillance or Helix, if you had any of that coming up.
Yeah, I'm working on some new Helix stuff right now. It's like, it's really just kind of in the ideas stage because it wasn't that long that I finished up Mourn. And then subsequently I've been handling all the pre-orders and the crowdfund stuff. Right. So once that stuff is all out of the way now, so I hope to dive into that a little more. I do want to do more Surveillance, but I kind of feel like we're living in a Surveillance album right now.
Pretty much.
And for me, the part of sort of, dystopian fiction is that it's fictional. So I might need a little time to, get past our current conundrum. Hopefully the election goes well. But I do plan to do more stuff with that project. I just don't know when.
Oh, Helix. Nice.
Helix is next.
Awesome. I enjoyed the Helix album very much. So that's exciting. All right, we'll go to Gold. So come on back for some more music. See you soon.
This is After Dark Radio, and you are listening to DJ Gold.
Code is law.
ears.
Flesh and bone into the danger. time to turn your eyes away? Is there a time for keeping your head down? Forgetting all of your day? Is there a time for cold and lipstick? A time for cutting hair? Is there a time for high street shopping? To find the right dress to wear?
Here she comes. Ooh, hair's turned around. Here she comes to take her crown.
Is there a time to run for cover? A time kiss and tell? Is there a time for different colors, different names you find it hard to spell? Is there a time for first communion, a time for E17?
Is there a time?
Here she comes, surreal in her crown.
beyond. My soul floating in the depth of nothingness, searching for an answer, just to find a question. What powers are hidden behind, controlling me? I'm
Welcome back to Community After Dark. I'm DJ Tom, and you just heard Stabbing Westward doing their cover of The Cure's Burn from the Crow soundtrack on the Cold Waves 2020 compilation out on Crack Nation Records. And then prior to that, we heard New Towow with a song called Trapped Heart, and that's remixed by Crom. I love that remix. It's really good. And that's from their latest release, Ritus Excellente, on Dark Tunes Records. And then prior to that, we heard Uncreated with a song called Without Warning from their latest Break Free EP out on Konzume Records.
Yes, and that is out now. We played a handful of tracks off of that before it was released, so that is now available. All right, the fourth song Gold Set, if you're counting, was by Major Voice and Friends. The song that Gold played was Miss Sarajevo, and that's a digital single which you can get on No Cut Records as well. Gold, yeah. Yeah, you want to explain that one?
Yeah, that's this is a charity song where they have members of Dennis from Solitary Experiments, members of Ice Fabric, members from Royce, along with Major Voice and a few others. I can't remember. You had the list. I lost it in front of me. But they do the cover of U2's Miss Sarajevo, and it's out on No Cuts. It's not available for consumption yet, but I guess they're going to put it out soon. But Dennis was nice enough to send it, and so I played it on the show.
Huh? Nice.
Plus, I like U2 a lot.
There you go.
It's like another super group.
Yeah, it's kind of like what was that one they did for We Are the World?
Band-Aid.
It's kind of like
we're
that.
We're never going to forget that. We're never going to forget. All right.
Didn't Wayne Hussey from The Mission just
Supergroup
thing?
Another supergroup. Yeah. And we played it.
Yeah, that they did a cover of an old Mission UK song called Tower of Strength, and they had everyone from like Gary Newman to both the Gene Love Jezebel brothers together for the first time in a while.
It's crazy.
You know.
There were no survivors.
Exactly. I don't think they talked to each other much when they made that song.
I think they did it all remote as well.
Yeah, they could have sent in everything from different parts of the world.
Yeah, remote. But that comes out, that one release comes out, I think, a little bit more towards the end of this month. Actually, pretty soon, I think. End of this month.
All right. Before that, this is the third track in Gold Set. Gold played Schubert and Valenk with the song Burn the Sun. That is a digital single on Treesoul Records. Is that the Schubert that we know and love?
Yeah, it's actually, I was in, it was before it was pronounced Schreiber.
What?
Schreiber.
Schreiber.
Yeah, Mel corrected me when we saw him at WGT.
Great, so another name that we've been saying wrong for years.
Yep, it's okay. better late than never, I suppose.
Okay.
I played Monolith with the title track to their latest, greatest album I've heard in a while that I like from them. It's called Natural Bodies, and that's out on Hands Productions. And then I started off with brand new Soman with a song called Code from their latest album, Global, out on Treesoul Records.
Soman's changed the sound up a little bit.
Yeah, it's a little more
I don't know what the word is. Maybe a little more house elements to it.
But there's aggressive vocals in it, though, like distorted vocals with it. He's got a couple guest vocals on it.
Yeah, it's an interesting album if you're into Soman and some of the previous stuff. But it definitely changed it up a little bit.
Yeah, well, him along with X Marks and Negative Format, I think, are the forefronters of mixing like trance in with like the industrial.
All right. Well, there's Gold Set. Good job, Gold.
I'm supposed to wish a happy anniversary to Marianne and Jonathan on 14 years of wedded bliss. So good job.
Wow.
Thank you.
A good run.
Congratulations.
There you go, Biblio Dude. So congratulations. Yeah, exactly. Congratulations. That's Biblio Dude, by the way, Mouse. He's been married for 14 years now.
Awesome.
So, yeah. So congratulations to him and his wife. And he had mentioned that he had bought your vinyl and absolutely loves the new vinyl, the way it sounds and everything.
That's great to hear.
And I think we have one additional comment we were going to read as well, if you have that, Mouse, I believe. Mm-hmm. I sent it over.
We have one more comment. This is from Bray of Provision, who says, "We are so honored to see ourselves appearing on this week's show. Wow, all our love to DJ Mouse for playing the title track of our new album, Hearts Turn Dark. Thank you, Mark, Tom, and Mouse, Communion After Dark, for your support." So thank you so much for appreciating it and tuning in, Provision. I really love your album.
I was unaware that he was, I guess I just forgot that he used to be on Different Drum as well at one time years ago.
Yeah.
I don't know if this is still the case, but we played a show with them, I believe in the last tour, which would have been 4 years ago, and his son was playing keyboards for him, which I thought was
wow,
like a family affair kind of deal. I thought that was pretty awesome.
That's great.
So, all right, well, there is Gold Set, and we are going to be going to Mr. Shear, our guest, our special guest from Assemblage 23. He will be doing a DJ set coming up here. Did you want to say what you're going to be starting off with?
Yeah, the first track is a track called She Mechanical by Mary Catman. A lot of people might recognize that name as my partner in Helix. She's also my partner in life. And she, you know, while I was working on the Assemblage 23 stuff, and she's been very patiently waiting for me to get some Helix stuff ready for her to do vocals with, she wanted to kind of branch out and do some kind of solo stuff. So she's been teaching herself a bitwig with a DAW, and has been really doing incredible things, like really picking up quickly. And so this is something that she did completely by herself and just released on Bandcamp on an EP called Eat.
All right, we'll come back and listen to that, and we will see you soon. Bye.
Bye.
Communion After Dark.
Hi, this is Tom Shear from Assemblage 23, and you're listening to Communion After Dark.
Breathing, my soul's been hot, I'm screaming on fire. to a three. I'ma do it for the pay. If you need another reference, I'ma need another day. All for the beats, but a bean going pay. Sit low boy, making money from his phase. I'm a dog, I'm an animal, it's all that I say. Bring it right back if you think it's all play. Poison be the pleasure if you think you got the trade. Love craft, golf trap, go and run another fade like whoa. Go and run another fade like whoa. Go and run another fade like whoa. Go and run another fade, go and run another fade. Go and run another fade like whoa. Go and run another fade like whoa. Go and run another fade like whoa. Go and run another fade, go and run another fade. Go and run another fade like whoa. Peace, back up in the city. Call me when she get the feeling. Oh, sheesh, I ain't really seen it. It's a leash looking tight if I really hit the ceiling. Eyes in the back cause I got a better taste. Only see the candlelight, I'm back to the shade. Poison be the pleasure if you think you got the trade. Love craft, golf trap, go and run another fade like whoa. Go and run another fade like whoa. Go and run another fade like whoa. Go and run another fade, go and run another fade. Go and run another fade like whoa. Another fade, go and run another fade like whoa. Bet you know me. Bet you know. Bet you know me. Bet you know. Bet you know me. Bet you know. Bet you know me. Bet you know.
Body. Not me. how you act and how you think in regard to others. Now that we know more about you, we begin to understand you a little better. Why did they see you one way and not as you really are?
Sentimiento.
Hi, I'm Tom Shear from Assemblage 23, and you're listening to Communion After Dark. And what you just heard was my guest set for the week. The set ended with an artist named Arca, and the name of the song was Manchote from the album Kick Eye. Arca is a non-binary producer and musician from Venezuela. They live in Spain now. And they really got a lot of notoriety for their music, to the point where they worked with artists like Bjork and Kanye West. And the new album is really great if you're into the more experimental side of things. It's not, you know, strictly an industrial album, but it's quite experimental and pretty out there in places. That was probably one of the more accessible songs off of it. It gets pretty weird, but
nice.
Highly recommend it. A really, really nice album. And before that, we heard Clack and their song Faith in Me from their new release, Probably. Clack, if you don't know, is Matt Finale from Caustic and Eric Oler from Null Device. And it's kind of their Belgian new beat project. It's not just that, it's kind of inspired by that, but they kind of tackle all the late 80s, early 90s dance genres. And this particular song, I think, kind of taps into the 90s era Depeche Mode sound a little bit. Before that, we heard Randolph and Mortimer and their song Body from their new release Manifesto for a Modern World. These guys are from Sheffield, UK, which is kind of appropriate, you know. That's where Human League and Cabaret Voltaire came, and of course, you know, the infamous industrial band Def Leppard.
That's awesome.
But Randolph and Mortimer are very, as you can hear, very like kind of a tribute to the old school of stuff. I think their stuff sounds a lot like the old Wax Trax record stuff. So I've been digging their stuff a lot. Before that, we had Street Fever and their song Animal featuring Coleman from their Gold Blood EP. I don't know much about Street Fever. I believe he's from Idaho.
Yeah, he's from Idaho.
Which is crazy, but if you like sort of the that like 110 BPM kind of Gesaffelstein like groove industrial, kind of married with a little bit of techno. I highly recommend his stuff. It's really good. Before that, we had Rain with her song Reincarnated from the album of the same title. This is her debut album, although she's put out a number of singles on her own. And, you know, like Randolph and Mortimer, I think her sound really harkens back to kind of the late 80s industrial sound. Her stuff reminds me a little bit more of like Network Records from that era than Wax Trax necessarily. But I love the entire album. Like, she does really kind of aggressive industrial dance stuff, but she can also really sing well. And there's some songs that are a little bit more almost pop oriented, but not with, you know, not in, in an obnoxious way. And then, of course, before that, you heard Mary Catman with her song She Mechanical off of her EP entitled Eat.
Nice. I noticed Mary's been doing a large amount of stuff on. She also did vocals. I had that one album I just got recently, Amp Void.
Yes, yep.
Yeah, that was pretty. That was a good combination with you know, her doing vocals and the music. I forget who the
so Scott Fox from My Varden Sphere and
okay,
Mika from
This Morning Mina. Was it yeah, from yeah. This Morning Mina? Okay,
I think that's right.
Yeah, sure that was a very
if I mess that up.
Very interesting release. I really actually really enjoyed that.
Yeah, she's been real busy with doing vocals with a lot of stuff. A lot of it hasn't even come out yet, that some of the really exciting stuff. So like,
right, she's done a large amount of guest vocals, because I know she also did stuff with at one time with like Simon Carter and Studio X and that a while back. And so it's done, yeah, definitely a large amount, and many other tracks too. All right, so I know we have some questions.
Sure.
for Tom.
All right, I have a couple. I have a one to think about, and then one a real easy one. All right, let's see. What sort of lyrical themes are you addressing on this album? And in what way does it differ from your previous perspectives on your other albums?
So this album is a pretty personal one to me. After we got back from the tour for Endure, I had a real bad episode of depression. I've always had depression, but it's never been debilitating. It's well treated, but this was something that was kind of at a level which I hadn't encountered before, and my life just kind of went off the rails, and I realized that I was going to need to make a lot of changes in my life to kind of get through there. And so the album is kind of about that period. You know, Epiphany is kind of about realizing, you know, recognizing the problem. And the album Closer, This House Is Empty, is about taking that step into kind of a new life.
Wow. Interesting.
That's amazing, yeah. Very interesting. Cole, you want to read your other question? Go ahead, man.
Oh, the other one's real easy. It's if you can have dinner with anybody from the past or present, who would it be?
I don't know. Probably George Carlin.
I think I
would want to have dinner with somebody who was really funny, and I really miss him, especially now. Like
he'd have a lot to say right now.
he would be doing very well for himself, I think. But I miss him a lot, and I really think that his voice is needed these days.
I find it interesting you said that about Epiphany, because when I was listening to that song and listening to your lyrics, because like I said, again, that's one of the things that's very big for me when I listen to music is the lyrics. It sounds, you know, that's what I got from it, was like you were trying to come across with, you know, saying that, you know, basically, you know, something had happened, you know, and it made you have this, you know, new look, outlook on things, you know, and yeah. You know, where you need to go. So I really that's really interesting. I mean, that you said that, and we appreciate you sharing all that information with us about the album. It's an amazing album, by the way. Very, very good album.
Yeah, I think this is the most rock solid, and you know, not that the other ones were bad, but this is completely rock solid album.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Yeah, and you started out on Gash Records of all places.
Yeah, that's right. And that was after, I think, 10 years of sending demos out and nobody
really returned. Wow. Go figure that one out.
Well, you know,
that's amazing.
A large part of it was that, you know, part of the time that I was trying to find a label to put my stuff out. In the U.S., everything that was coming out was kind of that Reconstruction Records, like the heavy guitar stuff.
Yeah.
It was very hard to get the attention of American labels if you were doing something that was purely electronic.
Right.
But, you know, of course, the tides shifted with that. And it was,
right. I remember
the timing being right.
Yeah, no, I remember that, because you had done that. There was a newer wave compilation, now that you bring that up, that was like on Reconstricted or whatever the label was again.
And didn't you? 21st
Circuitry.
21st Circuitry. That's what it was. Yeah. I could not. And you did that cover of Love My Way, correct? If I'm not mistaken, yeah. Or was it? Yeah.
Well, 21st Circuitry. Awesome. 21st Circuitry. They were taking chances on like Covenant, you know.
Yeah.
There was their early album. So that's good, you know.
Yeah, for sure.
And Ross, did you have
another question? Yeah, I had two questions. Okay, so one is, when you're performing live, what would you say is your favorite city or country to perform live in?
That's such a hard question, because
I know you don't want to leave cities out, but I mean, I know there's got to be places that you've performed in and you're like, this is amazing.
Yeah, every show that we've ever had in Sweden has been phenomenal. Like just incredible. I still remember a show that we played in, I think it was in Uppsala, and the crowd was singing so loudly along with the songs that they were drowning out the PA. Like,
wow.
I couldn't hear the tracks to sing to, and that was pretty amazing. We have great experiences in Germany, the UK. Mexico City has always been really good to us. We played with Funkervolk, and we played with a couple other bands there, and it was amazing. There was like 1,500 people there, and they were all just ready to go, and they went the whole night. Like, they're kind of a full tilt party crowd there. For the U.S., I mean, I'm not pandering here, but Orlando is always good.
Nice.
We have really good experiences in L.A. L.A.'s always been really good to us. Texas, New York. But, you know, some of the really amazing shows are also to, you know, in those areas where nobody ever comes. You know, we try to, when we tour, we play, obviously we hit all the major markets, but we also try to play places in between, of course, to fill in the dates, but also because we find that that's where you get a lot of the most appreciative audiences, you know, because they're just so glad anybody
they're so grateful
come to their town. And, you know, I grew up in a rural town in New Hampshire, so I appreciate that feeling of like, nobody's ever gonna come to my
No, it's nice.
I said Orlando and I meant Tampa.
I saw your DOS machine.
Close enough.
That was my mistake. But
I meant to say your city.
We've always loved having you in Tampa, always. And I know in Tampa in general, people just, well, I mean, the castle here, we've always played your music, and the crowd here just loves. I mean, you were here for Absolution last year, which was the only Absolution we've been able to do so far, but we're hoping to do more. but that was a phenomenal performance, and people were just so happy to have you here for that too. They really enjoyed that. Even later in the evening when you played, people were still going crazy, so that was awesome.
It's really amazing to see, you know, from around the time when we first started doing a lot of live shows, just to see how far the Florida scene in general has grown. Because back when we were first starting, it was always kind of a joke, like, you're going to play in Florida? Because there wasn't a whole lot going on there at the time. But it's gone on to become one of the bigger... I mean, I'm sure it's different for every band, but certainly in our experience, it's usually going to be the site of some of our larger shows.
That's nice. It's awesome. All right, so I guess we got a few more questions here, and then we'll let you off the hook here with all these questions we're asking. This might be a tough one, but just like, did you have somebody who inspired you to actually start making music?
I had a vague interest in music ever since I was really small, which was a bit odd because nobody in my family up to that point really had any sort of musical inclinations at all. So what really kind of changed things for me was when, this is going to show my age, it's when Gary Newman's Cars single came out in the U.S. And I was at my cousin's house, and we were in the backyard, and we were jumping on a trampoline. And we had a radio playing, and it was playing, like, whatever top 40, countdown. And Cars had charted that week. And it came on, and I just stopped, and I was like, what is that? Like, I'd never heard those sounds before, like, you know, those sort of ethereal strings and the electronic drums.
Yes.
And, you know, it wouldn't be until many years later that I would actually take steps to start learning about making electronic music. But I always point that as being the moment where I got hooked. You know, I didn't
That's
know
awesome.
What I was hearing. I just knew I wanted to be a part of it.
Nice. That's really cool. Yeah, no, it's a great, and that was a great track too.
You're fantastic. I mean, even with how overplayed it is, I still can't really get sick of it.
when I hear that beginning, the rumble, the you know, yeah. You're like, all right, here we go.
Yeah.
It's so good.
Yeah, I was gonna say you're not showing your age. Gold's always gonna be older than everybody.
Yeah, so I'm older than all of you guys. Yeah.
Did you have anything, you know, as far as like you wanted to say to the fans out there about this, you know, the new release or anything you wanted to convey to them at all?
I'm amazed thanks at the response the album has gotten so far. You never really know when you're releasing an album how it's gonna be received, and I've really been blown away by how enthusiastic people have been about it, and it makes it all the more frustrating that we can't be out playing these songs live right now. And I don't know how long it's gonna take for stuff to happen, but just know that Mike and Paul and myself are really looking forward to getting out in front of audiences and playing these songs live. And we'll do that as soon as we're able to.
Exactly, I know. I we're excited to have you come back around and play some shows. And you know, I know you're excited about that. I mean, yeah. Hopefully it'll be sooner than later. I mean, we can all hope for that, definitely.
Yeah, my philosophy with it is, as frustrating as it is, and I miss going to shows too a lot.
Sure.
But as much as I miss, you know, playing for people and going to see shows, I would rather not do that and let this thing get under control so that nobody's got to get sick and get their lungs all messed up or you know, heaven forbid, die. So I think
I agree.
A small sacrifice to make.
You're doing the right thing, and that's what, you know, I 100% agree with you. Your new album is amazing. Mourn is phenomenal. You need to go purchase that. It's available through Metropolis Records. It's available on Bandcamp. There's a single version. You can buy a double version through Metropolis as well.
We recommend the double set.
Yeah. And also the vinyl, the double vinyl, is that available through Metropolis as well? Okay.
People can also get the physical albums and shirts and stuff like that through assemblage23.bigcartel.com. Leave it to me to help up the pronunciation of my own band.
All right, so through your own website there, or through the Big Cartel website, Assemblage 23 Big Cartel website, you can get shirts, and what else can you get on there?
The
albums?
Shirt, the CD, the vinyl, and there's Helix stuff on there as well. So yeah, if physical media is your thing, that's the place you want to go.
Otherwise, like we talked about, you can definitely go to any digital, Amazon, Bandcamp, I'm assuming iTunes, you know.
Yeah, everywhere, all the streaming services.
All right, well, Tom's going to stick around with us for the last set, and then maybe we'll ask him one little more question before we go. But we really appreciate you talking to us, and, you know, again, Mourn is out. You know, definitely give that a listen. We've been playing a large amount of tracks on the show already from the album, so hopefully if, you know, people weren't familiar with any of the new stuff, they are now, but I'm sure our show is probably in the background with that, but anyways, we appreciate it very much, and Miles, I think you're finishing up the show?
Yeah,
no,
I'm next.
Maybe not.
I am next. I'm going to start out with Spank the Nun featuring Assemblage 23.
This is Communion After Dark Radio, and you are listening to DJ Mouse.
It's in my mind.
We'll be right back.
All right, Communion After Dark, welcome back to the third set of our show. I'm Mouse, and that was my set. And stick around, we have one more song after we chat. The last song you just heard was Sydney Vallette, who is French, I believe. That was the song PTSD that you can get on the PTSD/Nightcore single on Black Verb Records or on Bandcamp. And then before that is a new artist called Fall Shock. And that was the song Feels Eternal. The album is called Interior. And if you like oddball 80s sound modernized, this is for you. It's like dark wave, but like straight out of the 80s. And it doesn't sound like it's pretending to emulate it. It sounds like it's straight out of there. It's amazing.
It's kind of funny to me that we have this generation of bands that probably weren't even alive during the 80s, or at least were quite young, who were kind of reimagining that sound. I think it's a really interesting, I don't know.
I see comments all the time from young people saying, I wasn't alive in the 80s, but I feel it and I wish I was.
The third song in Mouse's set was Portion Control, and that was a song Telekinesis, the second version of that track, I'm guessing. That is off their brand new EP that just came out called Seed. Seed EP 1. And that you can get through Bandcamp. Portion Control has been around for many, many, many years.
Old school.
As they started in the 80s. So they're definitely an old school band. And they had just released...
That was one of the bands that influenced Phil Lieb from Frontline Assembly.
Oh my gosh.
Very old. I can definitely see that. Yeah, that I could definitely hear, especially with the early Frontline Assembly music. Yeah. You can definitely hear those influences. And Portion Control also had just released a brand new album as well, which is available. This EP just came out a little bit after the album.
Yeah, they did put out something in May that we kind of didn't get to.
Right.
Maybe we can go put back. It in the mix a little bit later.
There you go.
Well, prior to that, we heard Nabta with a song called Nice. And that's from their No Excuses release on Oraculo Records.
And then I started out with Spank the Nun, who we've played many times on the show. This is the song Fight and Breed, featuring Assemblage 23. That you can get on their album that was just released, The Bunker Tapes, Volume 1. And
yes.
And do you want to talk about this track, Paul?
It was something that they approached me about remixing, and I don't know. It's got kind of an old school sound to it. I don't know, it's more harder edged than I think people would normally expect from A23.
Yeah.
I always look at remixes as opportunities to kind of do stuff a little bit outside of my usual territory.
It's great. It's definitely for the dance floor. And by the way, we also had Eric Haynes from Spank the Nun on the show weeks back.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. A couple weeks back, yes.
Yeah.
Yep. And I did want to mention as well, because since we had highlighted Eric's album before, that, you know, and he had given all his pre-order, when he did the pre-orders for his new album, all that money had went towards Klaus Larsson and Kurt, who we wanted I want to send my love to them. You know, Klaus is an amazing person, and there is a fundraiser out there as well right now where you can help him out. It's the PayPal link we'll put in our notes so you can have that. But it's leatherstrip at vip.cybercity.dk and leather and then the underscore and then strip. So but we'll type that up and put it on there. So give help him out if you can. You know, Klaus is an amazing person, just all the stuff he's done for the scene, and hope for the best.
He's one of my favorite people in the scene. Like, he's one of the most genuinely nice, just sweet, kind-hearted people that I've had the pleasure of meeting.
Yeah.
which is very so funny to listen to. His music is so aggressive and angry, but he's really just the sweetest guy.
He is just, yeah, he's extremely, extremely nice person. You know, even like when I picked him up from the airport when he came here to play Tampa, I really didn't know him. He walks up to me and gives me a big hug. You know, so it's just, he's just a really wonderful person. Now we do want to, before we leave, we don't want to forget the people who are helping out our show as well, Continue Running. We did get some donations this week, which we want to read real quick.
Okay, donations. Thank you guys so much for helping us keep the show going. Remember, you can go to our website, communionafterdark.com, and the donate button is on the top. It's somewhere. There's donate buttons all over the place. So these are all monthly donations. So we got one from Frederick Lapham. Thank you. Greg Watkins Colwell, who is the Dark Lord of Serpents. Thank you very much. CD, thank you so much, who runs an EBM Discord.
Yes.
We should also drop a link for that. Ruben Carter, thank you for your monthly. Stephen Hall, Johan Rombach, Julian Tate, Biblio Dude, the one and only, Dave Steinhausen, Dea Siculus, Peter G, Megan Hunter, who we know, Amy Black from Maine, Kalani Robinson, Evan Wijninga, Chris Starr, Civil Rants. So thank you guys so much. We appreciate those monthly donations.
Thank you very much.
We also got a donation from the Snorts, who are local. Hope you're doing great. We got one from Clayton Nystrom of Fort Walton Beach, Florida. Thank you. One from Nicholas Mamatas, and one from Misty Publications in Chicago, who says, "Hi, Mark. After tagging you so much on Facebook, I felt like I owed you." Wow.
Wow.
Thank you, Misty. Misty Publications.
Misty Publications. Yes, I like that. That's awesome. So thank you to everybody who helped us out. We appreciate it. We know it's not easy, so we thank you very much for helping our show continue running. It means a lot. I do have to mention that we do have a guest next week, and not trying to... I just like, Tom Shear's here. No. I forgot. But no, Dirk Steyer, my buddy Dirk from Accessory, will be here next week. We're very excited to have Dirk back. He's coming from Chemnitz, he'll be joining us from Chemnitz, and we're very excited to have him back. He hasn't been on the show in a while. I'm sorry?
I was going to say, what kind of budget does this show have that you're flying?
I'm flying Dirk back in. Yeah, I wish Dirk was here. It's always a great time hanging out with Dirk, but we're looking forward to have him on the show again next week, so that'll be a good time. It's been a while since he's been on, so it'll be fun. So before we go to the last song, did we have anything else we want to say to our amazing guests? Besides, thank you, of course, for joining us, which I truly, truly, truly appreciate.
But I wanted to give a personal appreciation, Tom Shear. Your music has inspired me in the scene in my formative years. I was a teenager, and your music helped me through breakups. It helped me through grief. I remember being in my closet reading your lyrics over and over and over. And I, like every one of your shows that I've been through, I just cry. I'm just like emotional. And listening to emotional music like this got me into electro and synth pop. So thank you.
That's really nice to hear.
Cole,
yeah,
did you
I'm
want to
say anything? Yeah, I want to thank Tom for saving my dance floor every time.
Oh my God.
That's a good one. Hey, that's for sure. You're like a go-to on the dance floor. There's no doubt about that.
It's like, nobody's dancing. What do I do?
Put on Assembly 23 song. There you go. People start dancing. Yes. So thank you again for joining us. Again, we want to make sure that, you know, I know we've said it before, but Mourn is available. You can get it through... His you want to give the website one more time, Tom, that they can go to?
Assemblage23.bigcartel.com for physical media, assemblage23.bandcamp.com for digital, and of course you can get digital and physical through Metropolis Records as well through their website and their mail order.
Awesome. So, yep, the new album, Mourn, again, is available. The double CD is well worth it. The vinyls, if you love vinyl, which I do, the vinyl is definitely something you want to pursue, because I think vinyl just sounds so great, the quality of it. But we don't really have too much more. We don't want to keep you too much longer, so we really thank you for joining us. And Mouse is going to do, I guess, the last song of the show, and then we'll see you next week.
Okay, last song of the show. I'm going to play New Health, the band Health. This is their song Cyberpunk 2.0.2.0. And wow. This is on their upcoming Disco 4. And their disco is basically collaborations and remixes. That's going to come out on October 16th. So
I heard they did a song with Vin Diesel.
Did they?
I thought I read that they did a song and Vin Diesel did the. I wonder if that's on this upcoming thing. I don't know if that's true or not. I read something about it today.
That's got to be awful, though.
He probably does a reading like Riddick through it.
That would be cool. No, it looks like they have collaborations with like Use Code and Perturbator and Ghost Mane.
I don't know. Maybe somebody was just making a joke, but I thought that was.
That would be interesting. Vin Diesel doing vocals for Health. That'd be pretty interesting.
Maybe he reads the lyrics.
Maybe, yeah, the way I don't that know.
Gilbert Gottfried reads Cardi B lyrics.
Or like William, wow. William Shatner.
Yes. Tom Sherry, you were not supposed to know about WAP. It's all right. Okay, that's all we got.
All right, bye.
All right, bye, Sherry.
Thank
bye.
You. Bye. just a random question. Was there anybody that you would like to like open for or collaborate with, and like any like big artists that, you know, outside of yourself, of course, that you ever wanted to play with that would interest you?
I will say I was very jealous of Kanga getting to go out on the road with Gary Newman, because of the, you know, my connection to how he kind of got the ball rolling for me. You know, really any of those bands that were kind of influential to me, would be a gas. And that's been something that, you know, we got to open for OMD in Spain for a couple shows.
Awesome. No, that's awesome.
Yeah, I remember reading that. That was cool.
It's crazy. You know, like I have these moments. Like another moment would have been Cold Waves in Chicago. We were sitting in the lobby. We were waiting for to go down to the venue for sound check, and they would send a van down, and you would go down there with a bunch of other bands. So I'm sitting there in the lobby, and I hear somebody go, "Assemblage 23." I look up, and it's fucking Paul Barker.
Wow!
He was coming to tell us that the van
was
there.
That's awesome.
And I feel so lucky because, you know, I've gotten to do this for a really long time.
Sure.
I've gotten to meet a lot of people who were influential to me, you know, my formative musical years. And my first thought is always like, I wish I could go back to like 18-year-old Tom and say, dude, you're never going to believe what happens. Like, stick with this music thing. Like, you have no idea who you're going to get to play with. It's going to be great.
Yeah, I have to say That's this. Great. I mean, this is, hopefully you undertake this as a compliment, but when we first booked you, man, it was a long time ago in Tampa, and you were playing with Negative Format at the time, I believe. Negative Format was opening for you, and just the progression that you've made live and with the albums over the years has just been amazing. I truly believe that you're one of the best artists, especially in this scene. And I personally feel like there should be more recognition for artists like yourself than, you know, even beyond this scene, because I think the music is just, you know, amazing. And it reaches, you know, different levels and people's emotions and stuff when they listen to it. So
I think there's definitely a greater audience for this kind of stuff. It's just that I think the image and the fashion scares some people off a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And it's not really commercial, you know, so it doesn't get exposure in areas outside of our kind of, you know, our insular little scene. But, you know, we meet people at shows who were like not into this kind of music. You know, they're a lot of metalheads, like Cross 23 fans. And it's really cool. It's like, I'm just like, well, tell your friends, because I think there's a larger audience for this stuff. It's just a matter of people knowing it exists. I mean, that's the way it was for me. I didn't know about this kind of music until the first time I went to see Depeche Mode in 88. And they had a DJ who was playing like old Wax Trax stuff.
Oh, nice.
It blew my mind. I was like, whatever this is, I need to get a lot of it. So, you know, it's everybody has
that's
to have
awesome.
That exposure.
Well, yeah, you know, around that time too. So that's pretty awesome. Go ahead, Golem.
Well, I was just saying, even Depeche Mode had a hard time getting going because they were just a keyboard band, and you know, everybody expects somebody to be up there with a rock guitar god.
Yeah.
They don't feel comfortable till they see a guitar, you know.
Yeah.
But you know,
I believe it's Oraculo.
Oh, was it right?
Oraculo.
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 Okay.
Yeah, Oraculo.
Laughing very hard right now.
There's no right way to say. There's no way to say anything properly.
I wouldn't worry about it. There's not many Spanish speaking people in Florida.
You can say it backwards.
That's true.
Hola, Oraculo.
Will someone turn off that music?
That's enough. I'm putting an end to this freak show right now.
Mm-hmm.